legendary. That is what they used to call me. That was my title, my glory. Remember them when in hope you doubt.
You weaklings don't stand a chance. You shall perish against the rage of the Horde.
You filthy orcs are wrong. The might of the Allegiance is unbreakable, and we shall crush you as the beasts you are. Charge!
Charge!
Artifact, I was stunned by the darkness within it. I had never felt such a powerful evil. Yet, can good exist without evil? Can there be light without dark? And if that answer is no, then could it be possible that because this artifact exists, its polar opposite must also exist? To my surprise, the crystal itself had this very potential. And with the power of light, we turned this artifact into a source of purity, banishing the evil within. The crystal was reborn, and from it, a weapon was created. The weapon was given to me as a gift, and I wielded it with honor. In the name of the Crusade, I was the Ashbringer. Great power often implies jealousy, hatred, even from those you love. And I was betrayed.
The captured citizens should be close. We must reach them before the scourge. No, Father! Wait!
Make sure he is safe, Fairbanks. Thousand upon thousand they came. Yet I held my ground, sword in hand. Yet, as the ash was all that was left, something came that I was not prepared for. Fairbanks! Where are you? Fairbanks! Answer me!
What have you done, Reno? Why have you done such a thing?
Betrayed by my order.
I've had enough of this! If we do not learn from our mistakes, then the Horde will be destined for destruction. In his chamber, our so-called war chief is thinking. The fool is considering working with the Alliance once again. And in these dark times, oh yes, make no mistake, the Scourge is upon us. The Shadow is coming. But I tell you this, our time as pawns is over. Demons have controlled us. The Alliance has ordered us around. This time, we must stand alone. This time, we shall...
Sporisha! Do you question the wisdom of the War Chief? Do you wish to challenge him for leadership of the Horde? If not, then be silent. For as long as Thrall is War Chief, he decides what to do. I ask you again, Sporisha, do you question his judgment? Answer me!
No.
As I thought. Now, regardless of whether the Alliance will fight with us or not, it won't change the fact that war is coming. Preparations must be made. All of you, get back to work.
Even if we were to ally ourselves with them, the negotiations would take months. With all due respect, War Chief, we do not have that much time.
You are right, Morbid. We cannot afford to waste our time deliberating, all the while being held back by old hatreds. This time, the Horde must stand alone. Nevertheless, the Alliance is on our side in this conflict, and if someone forgets this, then I shall take action personally.
Tough round, eh?
Yes.
You know, you surprised me, Thrall. I would have expected you to be in favor of working with the Alliance.
Well, the council members shared your expectation today, and they definitely wouldn't have agreed with me.
I see. And since when have the opinions of others affected your judgment?
The truth is that they don't. As the War Chief, I am supposed to guide our people. I have to do what I believe is best for the Horde. But to be honest with you, old friend, my confidence in these humans and their allies has faded. They seem to have forgotten that we were the ones there by their side in the war against the Legion. Apparently, they now only care for animosity. Besides, Morbid is right. Negotiations would take too long. And for every moment we waste, the strength of the Scourge increases.
That may be true, but...
What? Since when has Sarufang, brother of Broxigar, been worried about a war? Of all the Horde, I would have expected you to be the first to raise your axe for such glory. Why are you so hesitant?
Maybe this time, Thrall. Maybe this time there is more at stake than honor and grudges.
There always is, my friend. There always is.
War Chief Thrall, Damok Natal is here.
Rexxar, what is he doing here?
Oh, well, I do need someone to keep an eye on the Alliance. Even though we may not band together, their movements are still important to us tactically.
Have you talked with the council about this?
You asked for my aid, War Chief.
Indeed, Champion. The Horde needs you once again. We must keep track of the Alliance, but sending an official member of the Horde would appear hostile. And as you probably realize, that is the last thing we need right now. Rexxar, are you prepared to aid the Horde once again? Always. Remember, Rexxar, we don't want to attract any unnecessary attention. Whatever you do, make sure you don't interact with the Alliance in any way. It is crucial that we do not cause any hostility between our two factions.
Settled it is. We shall make our preparations without the Horde. For at this hour, the Alliance once again works alone.
Commander, what news is there from Blazer of Eden O'Rory? Who goes in search for the Blade?
He has been given command of a unit from the Southern Bastion. However, as you well know, his searches are irrelevant. The Ashbringer was lost long ago. Besides, a more immediate threat has arisen.
Indeed. Yesterday, an army of Scourge infantry was spotted in Blasted Lands, near the Altar of Storms.
How many?
Thousands. Tens of thousands.
This is terrible news indeed. How can an army of this size have hidden from our scouts? We should have known of such a gathering weeks ago.
You are wrong. Do not underestimate the Lich King's power. For all we know, he... Lady Proudmore, what reason do we owe the honor of your presence?
Greetings, honored council. I apologize for my interruption, but I am here to further analyze the Book of Secrets. It is crucial that I am taken to it immediately. There is much at stake.
Of course. Sergeant Farmount, escort Lady Proudmore to the mage quarters, and please... By the titans!
You're being attacked! The Scourge besieges the gates!
Those blasted undead! To arms, warriors!
How many?
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 One bear per kill!
You can't be serious!
All right, you greedy bastards! Two bears per kill!
What?
It's the Scourge we're talking about, you fools! They're already dead! Now go! We need to get the civilians inside the city!
I have got a point.
Dana, come with me. I will take you to the book, but we must hurry. It has to be protected at all costs.
Of course. Lead on.
Listen, we need to take out the Necromancer now! Without him, most of the army will crumble. Rocco and Thornton, I need your groups to attack from the flanks. Make sure to distract them long enough for us to break through.
Understood! You heard him! Arkas Mordor!
No! He must not escape!
Thank you.
Con was a hell reserved for the betrayers. Vayner, this one's for Yimo.
Blazer. Blazer, we need to move. The men are waiting. Please, sir.
As you already know, this bastard we're chasing's gone north, and I've made my decision. Are you ready, lads? We're going to North Rend.
I've always heard that Northrend should be extremely cold, but this howling wind cuts to the bone.
Find peace within, Master Dwarf. It shall keep you warm.
I'd rather just stick to the usual, mate. Volatile rum, then.
Oh, well.
Sir, a group of dwarves have been spotted up front.
Dwarves? In Northrend? Those must be the last survivors of Muradin's expedition. I was hoping to find them here.
By the light, you don't understand. They are getting slaughtered as we speak.
No.
No!
This is terrible. We have to help them!
And by the Titans we shall!
No!
What?
You heard me, idiots! We can't afford casualties during this hunt. We need to be at full strength if we're gonna challenge Mowgli.
Full strength? But those are my cousins dying down there!
To hell with your cousins!
No! To hell with this vision!
If any of you follow him, you die by my sword! The undead will be eating their corpses by nightfall. Let's set up camp here. So, Gwar, you're saying that the Ashbringer's in the hands of Mograin, the Death Knight?
In its corrupted form, yes.
Well then, I guess we're going to have to sort that little inconvenience out, aren't we?
Mograin is a rather powerful adversary, Blazer. You cannot easily slay the one who has mastered the art of death itself.
Oh, is that right? Well, have you got any better ideas, Gwar? You are meant to be the wise one after all.
I suggest you find out for yourself, my friend. It is beyond my role to alter your destiny. Only you can explore that path. And Blazer.
What?
As you explore it, make sure you ask yourself this. Are you doing this for the sake of Azeroth? Or is it revenge that your heart seeks?
Don't you test me, Gwar. The only reason I'm doing this is to get Yimo back. That's all that matters to me, alright? Nothing else.
Blazer, in time you will have to realize the truth.
Oh, I need to realize the truth, do I?
Yes, Blazer. The truth. The truth is that your friend is lost forever. That nothing you may do will bring him back. It is only once you realize this that you will be truly free to choose your own destiny.
Destiny? What a joke.
Nice weather, huh? You know, I miss the Blazer of old. The man who would always make everyone laugh. But worst of all, I miss us.
Yeah, well, things change, Liana. Just go, will you?
But...
Not today, lovely. You're the only woman on this expedition, and I'm gonna take you just like I took your sister.
Please don't. Somebody, please help me.
You silly witch. Nobody can hear your screaming out here.
Liana, run. And don't look back. Now.
Hey, you. Mind your own business.
Wait. Wait.
Please, don't!
Bad call, brother.
Please, don't!
Son, you better wait to fall. They'll tell you where to go, but they won't.
Leave the horses.
Wait, they're corpses. They haven't been eaten.
Shh, listen.
Ourselves. My name is Mulgrave.
Well, mine's better. Mine's Blazer. And I am here to kill you.
So the rumors go. That is unfortunate, as it has been rather amusing to watch you follow his path. But it ends here. Slay them all!
Go! Now!
It's not working! He's resisting it!
No way!
Ha! You fool! Did you really think that the light would bring you down?
This can't be it. This can't be dead. But how can you combat death itself? Of course. Life. Liana! Heal Mulgrave now!
What?
Just do it! Now!
Perhaps now you realize the errors of your ways.
I never meant for this to happen. My destiny is sealed. Now kill me, or remain dead, you son of a bitch.
My time shall come, young one. But I have been released from my shackles, and I no longer serve Kel'Thuzad, nor the Lich King. Thanks to you, my destiny has changed.
To what?
Altering yours. You can either stay here and pity yourself for what you have done, for it is gruesome indeed, or you can follow me and I will show you the path of retribution. We both know what your heart desires more than anything. I can show you the way. Make your choice.
Show me.
Business does a Mokhnathal have in Dunmaroch?
I'm here to find out what kind of approach the Alliance is taking towards the Scourge, and I need you to tell me.
What? I would rather tell the Scourge than share that information with you wretches. I should kill you right where you stand.
But having saved your life, would my blood on your hands not disgrace your honor? Your hatred for the Horde is predictable. You're all the same. Understandable nonetheless. But I wonder if your wife, Tira, would have wanted her death to be the cause of so much anger.
How dare you! Ah! She was slain by the filthy hands of orcs, and you smell just like them.
Ah, yes, you are right. It is true that the orcs murdered your wife. However, the orcs that managed to get away from you were sentenced to death by Thrall himself. I was there, and I tell you, I have never before nor since seen such fury in his eyes. Perhaps the time has come for... for old grudges to be laid aside.
Maybe. Maybe not. Though I hate to admit it, you saved my life. We shall exchange information tomorrow morning. And follow me. I'll find a place for you in Ironforge.
So be it.
There is no way that we're going to take the book to Darnassus!
Yet we have no choice. The defense of Ironforge is severely weakened.
Not enough to let the book into the hands of the elves! Serventos! Will you explain to Ilarion here that there is no... What?!
Hi.
He's with me. Do not worry.
Well. Yeah, okay. Whatever you say, mate. Well, we're trying to figure out how to keep the book safe, and these elves here dare to suggest moving it to their city! It's an outrage!
But Talarian is right, though. Ironforge has been weakened, and the nobles of Stormwind refuse to shelter the book. If the Scourge were to come back now, we wouldn't stand a chance.
Then we shall die defending it.
So you would die knowing it was in the hands of the Scourge? But you know we cannot take that risk. What?
There is one city that has been reinforced for months. We could take it to Ogrimmar.
You may have a point.
What?
Not even the Lich King would expect that.
For a bloody good reason!
Yes, but maybe the time has come for the unexpected. Rex and I can travel there. I wish to meet Thrall myself. Now, if there are no objections, then I think we better get some rest while we can. Follow me, Rex.
What was that about?
That's none of your business, alright? Now, where's your mount?
I prefer running.
Ach, be my guest. Yarr!
We have traveled for 3 days, yet you've barely spoken a word. What is it that darkened your mind, Master Dwarf?
You wanted to know what I was discussing with Minori? Well, I'll tell you. As you know, Jaina Proudmoore is on her way to Orgrimmar as well, carrying the book that the Lich King sent an army to retrieve. But what you don't know is that Minori demanded to lead a decoy group traveling to Darnassus.
A decoy group?
Aye, a larger group than Jaina's, which will appear to be bringing the book to Darnassus as a distraction.
I understand.
Yes, if a distraction does not work, we may be doomed. And if it fulfills its purpose,
Minori will die.
And a grudge will be written. But we must go if we are to convince Thrall before Jaina arrives. Ogrimmar's that way, right?
Yes.
Bloody show off.
The spirits told me of his return. Welcome back, champion.
Loktar, warchief.
Ah, and you must be Serventos. Your fighting spirit is well acknowledged among the orcs. What brings you here, dwarf?
Ironforge has been attacked by the Scourge.
Hmm. I assume they came for the book Jaina told me about. Were they able to take it?
No. That's why I'm here.
I see. You want us to protect it.
What? This is absurd! The retrieval of this book is the main objective of the Scourge!
Nevertheless, Jaina Proudmoore is on her way with the book. I fear a decision must be made at once. Very well. Ogrimmar shall aid in securing the book. May our walls protect it.
Thrall! With all due respect, we cannot allow ourselves to endanger Ogrimmar like this. Let the Alliance handle this themselves.
Enough of this! We would be risking far more if the Lich King gets what he wants. Now, Rexxar and Serfentos, you two shall come with me.
You have our gratitude, Thrall.
So, tell me, how far away is Jaina?
She may arrive any moment from now.
Have you made the proper distractions?
Of course. A decoy group has been sent towards Darnassus. It's being led by one of our officers, Minori Silverleaf.
That Minori?
Aye, that Minori. They should be somewhere in Ferelas by now.
My. I've been looking forward to meet you, Minori. It appears that you have something that I need.
It's the Lich King himself.
Do not smoke. You're quite brave coming here alone, Arthas. I guess immortality has strengthened your foolish ego. Shouldn't you have your little army with you?
Aldario, be ready to flee on my signal.
I'm afraid they won't get far. You're quite bold for an elf, but then again, so was Sylvanas. Now, if you excuse me, I'll take what I need.
You stupid man! None of us carry the book that you seek. Your self-confidence, your arrogance has misled you, and you have failed.
The book? Oh, you are mistaken, for you see, I never fail. Let me show you the truth, Elf. Close your eyes and watch.
Aye, that was quite a fight back there. It's been a while since I've had one of those. Oh, of course. I'm sorry for the loss of your friends.
What is this place?
This place is what Azeroth would have become had it not been for our interference. But though it may appear to be similar to Azeroth in many ways, you will notice that many of the usual boundaries do not exist here. Hunger, sleep, even time is irrelevant. This place is called the Nunimisha by the elves, but you probably know it as the Emerald Dream. Quite an amazing sight, huh?
brought me here?
Because we're going to train, Laser, until you are able to defeat me. And that may very well take years.
Just, you know, in case we're counting, I have actually killed you already once today. Are we going to need to do this again?
Bah, you fool. I was in a weakened state back there.
Ach, wee Mulgrain was in a weakened state. Poor wee Mulgrain. What a terrible excuse.
Right now, you don't stand a chance against me.
You'd be a fool to underestimate me. I'd show you, old man.
This is why I chose you, Blazer. You may not have talent. You may not have any particular strength or skill. But you have an unlimited potential within you. And you have the dedication and spirit to master this potential. But let me make one thing clear to you. This is going to take years of training. It will be painful. A true torment. And if you're going to give up because you're afraid, then you might as well do it now.
And why do you think I have this potential?
Having trouble believing in yourself after all, eh? I'll show you. This is the Nakra Circle. My guess is that you'll be able to survive here for 3 days. That is the record so far.
You're off your head, brother. 3 days? How's that gonna prove any potential? What a waste of time.
Oh, you'll see. I'll be back in 3 days.
Oh, so this is training? Yeah, right. This is stupid.
To save Blazer, but they killed Mary.
I see. If they want him so badly, we must make sure he has the proper protection.
Don't worry. I'll take care of him.
Seems like everyone nowadays chooses fear, hatred, vengeance. Even me. You taught me to forgive. You taught me something more than just to hate. And I forgot. I don't know how and I don't know when, but I forgot. And I failed you, Yimmo. I failed you.
You see the sunset, Blazer? It always reminds me of what we're fighting for. It reminds me of the dark times that will come. But it also reminds me that as long as we fight this darkness together, then the light will return and a new day will come again. Never forget this.
You can trust me, old friend. I won't let you down. Not this time.
Thank you.
Baldy! You better prepare the next test.
You're not done yet. I told you, you're supposed to survive for 3 days down there. Now stop fooling around.
Well, credit where credit's due. At least this fella's dead. What the... So, why do you keep bothering? Well, you're already dead, you know. I mean, what's the point in going through all this?
We're all going to die someday, Blazer. So what's the point in living?
I guess we hope to achieve our goals in life.
And your goal is revenge, is it not? Listen, I am no judge, but let me tell you this. The lust for vengeance is crude and dark. It leads only to suffering. Yet if you are able to channel the rage within, to harness the power of your emotions, then you will be able to become a vessel of retribution. As I promised you 3 days ago, I will teach you this path, the way of the Paladin.
So you're telling me that I'll be following in your footsteps as the next Ashbringer?
Indeed. That is my only goal left in life.
I hate to break it to you, man, but, you're not alive. You're dead. Even now, when I'm saying this, like, you're still dead. Just right now. I don't want to get cross wires, but we should, you know, be aware.
At least you're still alive, Jaina.
Yes. But the book has been taken, and Thrall... That book is the lost book of Medjiv.
The Prophet? Are you sure?
Yes, of this there is no doubt.
It makes sense. After all, we're no longer fighting Arthas alone. He has merged with a being formerly known as Ner'zhul, an orc shaman like myself. And I think I know why he would want this book.
Yes. During the Third War, we fought Archimonde, who was summoned here with the book of Medjiv. While Archimonde was defeated at Mount Hyjal, his brother, Kil'jaeden, was still in command of the Burning Legion.
True. I was there myself. What has this got to do with the book?
Kil'jaeden was the one who devised the orc invasion of Azeroth. He lured Ner'zhul to deceive his people, but eventually Ner'zhul refused. As punishment, his body was torn and his spirit was tormented for years.
So the Lich King wants revenge.
Yes, and besides that, Kil'jaeden is most likely the only being that the Lich King considers a challenge. He is going to use the book to summon Kil'jaeden and defeat him here on Azeroth.
Well, isn't that, like, brilliant?
Yeah, Dwarf's got a point.
Naturally, a battle of such magnitude would be the end of Azeroth.
Oh, okay, my bad.
The book must be destroyed.
Yes! Let us retrieve it and throw it into the flames of Black Rock Mountain. What?
That is not an option. An artifact such as the Book of Medjiv will have to be neutralized.
Neutralized?
Yes. If you try to destroy it in an ordinary way, you'd cause an enormous release of arcane energy. In such a case, we might as well just let them fight.
Would you be able to neutralize the book if you had the chance, Jaina?
Yes, but it would take a lot of time, and I would only be able to perform the spell once. But besides, we don't even know where he is going to take the book.
Tell me, Thrall, Serventos, has any strange scourge activity been reported lately?
Now that you mention it, we did discover a surprisingly large reinforcement of the Scourge outpost in Blasted Lands.
Of course. Those Scourge legions are protecting the shield barriers of Noxramas. By summoning Kil'jaeden inside the necropolis, Arthas will have a slight advantage against his enemy.
So, if we can get inside, we might be able to destroy the book before the summoning is complete. It may be a long shot, but it's all we have.
Then Jaina and I shall gather a small group to enter the necropolis.
Rexxar, can I count on you to lead the Horde into battle? We need to bring those shield barriers down if we're to enter. Of course, I won't let you down.
Neither will the Alliance. In this fight, we stand together.
So be it. Blow the horns of war. Let them know there is still hope for those that choose to fight for it.
Says Durotar. They've got them all over the place. In truth, I always imagined that it would be my son sitting here. But this isn't too bad at all. Letting your rage overwhelm you. You have to control it. Focus your anger. Focus, Blazer. Focus, Blazer. When I was about your age, my father told me something.
From today, you may call yourself a paladin. When a man in our family reaches this goal, he is taught the battle poem of our kin. When your foe hears this in battle, he shall tremble, for he will know that you are one of the Duranin.
The poem that my father taught me was this. When shadow comes to claim our souls, some must rise, the light of old. Names in stone, spirits of legend, deeds unknown yet never forgotten. These are the Duranin, of honor within and of fear without. Remember them when in hope you doubt. From today you may call yourself a Duranin. Are you prepared to carry my burden?
I am. But if I'm not mistaken, blade's still corrupted, right?
Yes. My soul is still torn by the corruption within, and the Ashbringer will always be bound to the soul of its wielder.
I have learned your secret, Vada.
but nothing will prevent me from getting your power. I will never let you overshadow me again. The next Ashbringer is me.
But then...
Yes. To succeed the Ashbringer and wield the blade, you must first kill the wielder. By doing so, the souls of the Ashbringer and his killer will fuse together, and the blade will go on. Unfortunately for my son, he did not have the potential to be accepted by the blade.
So you're trying to tell me that I have that potential, that even your own son didn't?
Yes, Blazer. And your final triumph is to kill me with my own blade.
No. No. Not now. This isn't supposed to be how it happens.
Blazer.
Being like a...
That is your burden, Blazer.
No.
Whether you like it or not, you are the only hope for Azeroth.
Stop it!
They need you.
I refuse. I can't do it. I can't.
Then you are letting them down. If you just keep thinking about yourself, then you'll be no better than the Lich King himself. What about the sacrifices? What about them?
Shut up!
Is Emo's sacrifice going to be nothing? Because of your pitiful weakness?
No!
Serfentos, you were about to tell the officers about the tactics for the front lines.
Aye. Some of you already know the Dwarven Hammer. The target is the altar, here. We have sent rogues from the Forsaken into the area. If we're lucky, we'll be able to cut down the acolytes that keep up the shield barrier. In that case, Jaina and Thrall's group will be allowed entrance into the necropolis.
When the shield is down, I will be able to teleport us inside. I wish I could bring another group inside as well, but the teleportation would require too much of my stamina.
Don't worry, Jaina. I have brought the best warriors from the Iron Edge and Ravenous clans. We'll be fine. Ain't that right, boys?
Good. Because our presence will most likely be known as soon as we enter the necropolis.
However, it is crucial that we capture and hold the altar for as long as possible. We have to prevent the Scourge from supporting the shield with new acolytes.
According to Jaina, the shield will instantly kill every living being inside the necropolis. So that's why we use the Dwarven Hammer to lure the Scourge away from the altar. The main army will stand their ground here. As the Scourge charges, room will be made for the two flank attacks and... What is it, Rexa? Oh well, seems the Scourge already knows we're here. Rocco, make sure everyone gets our directions.
Alright. Randolph, Morbid, your regiments will take position here.
I've been wondering, is this a battle we can win?
Winning is not always the goal of fighting. Do you remember Blazer?
Aye, but we haven't heard from him since he went to Northrend to chase the Ashbringer. He's probably dead by now.
Maybe, but if that is so, he died fighting for what he believed in. He inspires them. They fight for the ones they love. For the future, they fight for hope. I say we crush those undead.
Aye, let's give them hell.
Something bothers me. Yimo sacrificed himself so that the book could not be completed. Yet Arthas doesn't seem to be bothered by any of this.
I think I know why. During the battle at Ironforge, I came in contact with the book, and, not to brag or anything, but I fear I might live up to the demands of the book. My purity, and stupidity has probably completed the book and made Jimo sacrifice himself in vain.
Jimo sacrificed himself for those he loved. For us. Such sacrifice is never in vain.
True. You know, I should probably hold some sort of speech, as we're almost likely going to die in there. But, I kinda decided I didn't want to make it all dramatic. So instead, I brought some great ale.
Heroes of the Horde and the Alliance. Unfortunately, we've been having a lot of grave digging lately, and I believe it's time to put the corpses back where they belong.
What we face today may be death, but we also face hope. No more shall we hide in fear from the shadow of the Scourge.
No longer shall old grudges blind us from the truth.
No, for now, the time has come for us to stand together and face our enemy.
Today, our terrors will become his. We rise to fight.
Loktar Ogar!
Victory or death.
Audience, but I'm afraid you're slightly too late. The ritual has been completed already, and it's only a matter of time now. You know what I speak of, don't you, Jenna?
Then it seems we shall have to fight him.
No!
For a leader at all, and yet you call yourself War Chief.
As I expected, you were nothing but a bunch of weaklings.
Couldn't let you die. Now could I?
Roll!
Are you okay? I'm so sorry. I should have been faster.
Do not worry, dear. You did your best.
So, it looks like this is the end.
I may still be able to distract him.
If you're thinking about using that trick of yours, then...
Then what? I am Warchief of the Horde, and right now, my people are risking their lives to give us a chance.
Give up?
I would rather die with honor than live without. Now, give me a hand.
Wait. I feel some sort of presence.
It is about time.
I've felt this before, but that was years ago, and it can't possibly be him.
By all means, put on that little crown of yours. I didn't come here to play.
I see. Then I'll make this quick. After all,
I have a summoning to attend to.
So that's how it is. Well then, let us begin.
Not so bad.
What the hell's going on here?
The summoning process. It's becoming unstable. We're running out of time.
Are you all right?
Blazer, you have to let us help you. You can't defeat him alone.
Shut up. This is my fight. Mine. All of this chaos. If it wasn't for my foolishness in the past, so much pain could have been avoided. I have to make up for my mistakes.
You're wrong. No fight can be won alone. Don't you realize this battle decides the fate of the entire world? If you fight only for yourself, then you're nothing more than a damn fool.
All right. If you're able to hold him still for just a moment, I should be able to finish it with a single blow.
I have an idea. If you can keep him busy long enough, you'll get your chance.
Oh, don't you worry about that, man. It'll be a piece of cake.
Gina, you said the magical energies from this summoning were causing this change of location. Are you able to alter those energies in any way?
What do you mean?
We need to go somewhere special.
Let me tell you a little secret, Laser. The sword you're wielding is a key. Using it, you would be able to not only undo the summoning, but you might also be able to release the soul of your dear friend, Yimo.
Why should I believe you?
I never lie. I'm simply telling you because there is no way you can defeat me. And I would love watching you die in agony, realizing that you failed them all again.
So tell me something, Arthas. What is your goal in life?
My father wanted only to rule his own kingdom. Let's just say his lack of ambition was his weakness. This battle is but a piece in the puzzle.
Oh, I see. Well, in that case, I'll let you in on a little secret of my own, shall I? This piece won't fit. When shadow comes to claim our souls, some must rise the light of old. Names in stone, spirits of legend, deeds unknown yet never forgotten. These are the Duranan, of honor within and of fear without. Remember them when in hope you doubt.
So, the legend was true. When one kills the Ashbringer, the two become one.
Yeah. And if you think that's cool, watch this.
Gina, now make sure we remain here. Sarfang!
Yes, Thrall.
I smell demons coming. I need you to cover me. Alakir, I call upon you. Lend me your strength!
I hope you're counting rocks.
Here, Serventus.
So, he did not only kill you, he decided to turn you against us. Then I shall grant you rest, my friend. Make him pay, Blazer.
Make him pay!
You mortal fools! You are no match for me! No!
I told you.
I did it.
You are no match.
No! Laser!
I believe it's time to reconsider that statement.
That was some pretty nice fight back there. For a human, of course.
He's still alive? Yet, he seems different.
Yeah. While Frostmourne turns the wielder into a Death Knight, corrupting the soul within, the Ashbringer has the ability to reverse this effect. I guess Arthas was able to survive this. I think you should take him with you.
What? There's no way I'm taking more than his head with me!
It doesn't matter anyway. Look, the summoning is almost complete. This world, our world, will end.
You heard what he said.
The sword you're wielding is a key. Using it, you would be able to not only undo the summoning, but you might also be able to release the soul of your dear friend, Yemo.
And how can you possibly believe he would be telling you the truth?
That's not the point. I believe it's worth trying. And from what I've heard about you, Lady Proudmore, you should be able to teleport everyone outside safely. I'll stay and deal with this.
That determined look on your face reminds me of Grom Hellscream. If this is what you want, Blazer, I will honor your wish.
But there has to be some other way.
There always is. But after all, it's a good day to die.
Indeed, it is.
Loktar Ogar, Blazer. Yemo and yourself will live on in our hearts, and your tale shall be sung amongst the Lokvadnod of the Horde.
Sounds like a plan, brother. Just make sure to remind them all how handsome I was. All the best, guys. Goodbye.
Hey, Blazer. What took you so long?
Oh, hey, you can talk. You found my hatchet.
Gina, come on! Some people believe destiny to be unchangeable. I disagree. For today, we have won a victory. Not only against the Lich King, but an even greater victory against ourselves. By standing together despite grudges and hate, we have won a battle against the evil within us. An evil that was destined to be our end. And today, the red sun rises in the east and grants us a new dawn. Look. It reminds us that one being may make a difference. Blazer never believed in destiny, but he believed in hope. He believed that nothing is unchangeable as long as we try. That hope, that belief, is what makes a hero out of any man. In Orcish, such heroism has a name. Lok Narad. Though there is no exact translation for it, it roughly resembles one word. Legendary. That is their title. Their glory. And I ask of you that you do one thing. Honor them!
Someone bring me another bear.
I say, that was quite a tale. I wonder though, whatever happened to Arthur?
So do I. Oh, by the way.
Nice tale. Almost warmed my heart.